when do you put this shield up? You know, Adam would do it a lot. Like, how you do one thing is how you do everything. So it wasn't just to me, it was to everybody. Mm. Because when you withhold love from yourself and a certain person, you do it to everyone. And you're doing it because that person or that event or that situation triggers that same feeling that you had when you were a child, maybe before the age of 7 or 12, even as an adult. It triggers that same feeling that you felt when a certain person let you down, when your trust was betrayed, when you know, you were hurt, when you were rejected. You know, identify when this defining moment was for you. When was this defining moment? And maybe you've got several. If you can identify them, and that meditation will help you do that, you will see that this is not you. It's a pattern you're running. Like Adam said, we are love at our core. Every single one of us are love. We came from love. We're here to love. This fear and the hate and the separation is something we have learnt. And it's been learnt as a way of trying to survive. But it's actually... it's depriving us of the very thing.
Keeping us trapped, yeah.
It's depriving us of the very thing we need to survive, which is love. So, you know, for Adam, one of those moments in his life was in high school.
Yeah, one so in high school there was, you know, I think I was probably in about year 11 maybe, year 10 or 11. And we had just a normal sort of speech that you have to give in English. And I had to stand at the front of the class and give the speech with someone else, one of my buddies. And I just froze up. One of those moments where I just completely froze. For some people, you know, you might miss a few words or you might stutter or, you know, you might have to restart the little bit you were just speaking about. But I actually completely froze. Mm. I couldn't even talk. And that, I went into like a cold sweat and it was, my heart was just pounding out of my chest. And that event created quite a lot of trauma. And I guess it made me feel like it. And it wasn't until a lot later on that I actually joined the dots and realized that's the event that created it. But it was essentially making me feel like it wasn't safe to open up and express myself and talk to a number of people at any one time.
Yeah,
like definitely. Speak to crowds or do a public speech.
Yeah.
So it was a really...